What do I think about French people? That's there better. It is. I've just been
Thank God.
I've just been asked what I think about French people.
What do you think about French people?
I think they make the best food in the world.
That's an interesting on-the-fence answer. I thought the Scots and the French were supposed to be an old alliance.
Yeah, only in hatred of the English. And that, you know me, I'm not like that.
Oh, well, fair enough.
How are you, Hansel?
I'm doing all right. I'm doing all right. Just, you know, trying not to go crazy. How are you?
I'm okay. I'm very lucky. I'm my flat's got like a terrace and it's full of books and guitars and stationary bike and stuff. So I'm very fixed and alive.
I live in a shoebox.
Yeah, of course you're living there. Well, you moved to New York. This is what happened.
Yeah. Yeah, no garden for me. But they're not quite as strict about, I mean, there's nobody outside, so you can like go, you're allowed to go outside to exercise a little more.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Agag. Is that something in a language that I don't know? What do you think about coming to India?
I would love to go to India. I was actually meant to go there next month to visit, but it got cancelled. I was going to go travel around a bit.
I was supposed to be in Florida and New York. Now, pretty much, I suppose, just getting back from there, yeah.
I know. What have you been doing with your day so far?
Shopping, mostly.
How are you doing that online?
No, I went out to get shopping for me and my parents and my elderly neighbours.
Oh, that's so nice.
So I'm being very, very good. How is quarantine? Well, yeah, I'm trying to get out as often as I can whilst having a legitimate reason, like doing something for someone else who really can't go out.
Where'd you go?
Tesco. It was very exciting.
Have I ever heard of fan fiction? Yes, I've heard of fan fiction.
Oh, careful. Where's that going to go?
I don't know.
Is anyone going to visit Louisiana? Yeah, sure, I guess. I don't. Actors have a tendency to mostly go to places where other people ask them. Come more than
yes,
more than actually pay for our own trips.
Yeah, I see you have Lord of the Rings over your shoulder.
I thought I'd do that thing that the politicians do, where they curate their bookshelf.
Oh yeah, for the did you? Did you curate it? What else is there? Philip Pullman.
Pullman.
Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings.
Christmas cards.
Christmas cards. No, that's. I've got sketches by Boz Dickens.
Oh yeah.
I've got the Penguin History of the World.
Nice. Short.
Yeah. Very short, you know, given the subject matter. Wise Guy, which is the book that Goodfellas is based on.
Oh yeah.
And a book called Why We Sleep, which I've not read.
Why do we sleep?
I was interested to see that book exists because, as far as I understood, it's something that is a complete mystery to modern science. We still have no idea why we sleep. That was my understanding of it. But
oh, that's interesting.
Maybe not. Maybe he's going to tell me different.
I'm so glad we do. Should we be answering these on a globe? Wow. Do you sit and spin that and then just? I would just sit there, spin it, and then put my finger on it really hard, like I was in a movie about someone who wanted to go somewhere.
I would do that if it was a real globe, but it's...
Oh, of course. I should have guessed. Yeah. Within reach of the reading chair.
We probably should be asking some questions. Sorry, we're just talking to each other. We can do that anytime.
Yeah, we're just catching up.
Do we get annoyed when people associate us with Harry Potter? I mean, this would be a strange thing to be doing if we got annoyed about that.
Yeah.
I think it's quite a privilege to be part of something that huge, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. It's nice to be associated with anything, frankly. unless it's like criminal activity, in which case, probably best keep it quiet.
Christian, why is your last movie not available in France? What is your last movie, mate?
What is my last movie? Bite Me? Oh, it's probably... I think there's distributors... Actually, it was meant to be... we were meant to be getting distribution through Berlin this spring, but Berlin didn't happen, so I don't actually know what's happened with that.
Yeah, that's going to play havoc with independent films, eh? Festival's not happening.
The last TV show I did might be available in Europe soon, High Fidelity. But it just cancelled.
Someone asking if we would go to MCM Comic Con.
Where's that?
If they ask us, I suppose. I think it's in Birmingham. Or they might have a few. I'm not sure. I'm not being too.
Oh, okay. I'm shaking. Me too. Have you guys been on tour? Have you been to the Leavesden tour? I haven't. People keep telling me about it, but I haven't been there since it opened.
I have. I went once about 5 or 6 years ago. It's kind of amazing, actually. The start, yeah. I want to tell you, if you don't know already, I don't want to tell you how it starts.
You don't spoil it for people.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, of course. I genuinely had goosebumps with the way it starts. I thought it was kind of remarkable.
That's cool.
We've been in the Czech Republic together.
That's right. We filmed Charles II there.
Charles II. We were both in Charles II, which was how long ago?
I don't even want to say, but it was 18 years ago.
You feel like you're still young, so you remember jobs you did 20 years ago.
I do remember that Potter 5 came out while we were there, or 6, and we sat. Probably no. 5, and we sat. I think 5, and we sat. Yeah, and we sat and read it in the. I bought it from the English bookshop there.
Sorry,
and
I thought you were talking about the film. Yeah.
And David Bradley was on that job, who played Filch.
Yeah, and Shirley Henderson, who played Morning Myrtle.
Shirley Henderson.
That was a great little reunion. So these questions.
I know. So fast. It's really like being bombarded.
Did I pick up any new hobbies during quarantine? No. I've just been doing existing hobbies much more, like cooking and reading and playing guitar.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I passed that guitar shop that you went into the other day.
I'm still annoyed the one in Williamsburg for not buying that guitar, but I couldn't really afford it at the time.
Maybe it's still there. I'll check. someone just asked if I would do ASMR. I do audiobooks, so if you want to hear me whisper to you gently, you could always buy one of those.
What's ASMR?
It's that thing where I'll do it for you. It's when people whisper into microphones about things like, I'm now opening a packet of crisps. Like that. And people get, it's like a kink people have.
Right?
Yeah, or they rustle things. They just talk very quietly.
That's an established thing to the point where it has a
ring. Yeah, it makes people feel calm and it makes other people feel sexually excited.
Okay.
It's like a whole thing.
Well, every day is a school day, even when it's not. In fact, particularly when it's not.
I think Those Who Wander is probably available to watch online. You'd have to ask Bonnie, though.
I'd forgotten you'd done a thing together.
Yeah.
I was supposed to do a film with Bonnie in 2012, but it fell through. Anyway, people keep mentioning the Czech Republic, but I can't see what they're saying about the Czech Republic because it disappears so quickly.
I also can't read Russian. Someone just asked something in Russian, but if you translate it, I will do my best.
Are you bilingual? Is your French good enough that you would say you're bilingual?
No, I can. It's like GCSE. It's GCSE English, French. My mum and dad live in Belgium, so I maybe get more opportunity to occasionally brush it up.
That's why I thought you might be all right. My mug, as someone just asked, it's a King of the Mountain mug. It's the handle. The handle is a little bicycle.
Oh.
I like cycling.
It's like almost a knuckle duster mug.
Yeah. Fantastic Beasts, yeah, I saw the first one. I haven't seen the second one yet, though. Christian, will we get to see you in Fantastic Beasts?
I don't know. Nobody, I mean, if they offer me a job, sure. Or if they ask me to, you know, be in it, I would love to. It's really interesting. That's the third Pirates of the Caribbean question, or you've asked it 3 times. But I barely made it through the first one, so I'm probably not a great person to ask.
I thought the first Pirates was great fun, and then it was Diminishing Returns very much. But
what's the first thing you'll do after the quarantine? God, that's a good question. Sort of depends how it ends, I guess. But I think probably be in rooms with groups of real people.
Yeah,
is the thing that I, for all this like digital chatting, it doesn't feel. It feels a little bit like junk food. Like you get the illusion of sustenance, but not the it's not the same as being in a room with someone. Yeah.
To be honest, I actually do it very little because I find it such a poor substitute that I haven't really bothered.
Yeah. What do you do for your mental health of the day? You get outside as much as possible, you said, or you run errands for people if you can.
I run errands for people. I get outside. I'm lucky. I've got like I can sit in the window and there's plenty of sun and I can read and kind of feel like I'm not too cooped up by doing that. And I've got my bike is on a turbo trainer in a living room, so I'm still getting plenty of exercise even though we're locked down.
Oh, so that's like it's on a thing that you can
yeah,
you can like exercise on it.
Yeah, you take your back wheel off and then you put the bike on it and the chain turns a flywheel instead of. So it's,
are you allowed to go cycling in Glasgow outside or no?
Yeah, we can. But I mean, I don't do like long distances because I've got a dodgy knee, so I'm actually better off just sitting in the house for a little while. But I might go cycling with my dad for a bit. If the weather improves.
Oh, yeah.
Right, more. Anyway, my hobbies. What's more questions? Christian, what's your aesthetic?
I saw that one. I don't know what the answer to that is, but I guess I don't know. Like, I mean, this is my apartment right now, so yes, there's color, grays, and color would be the answer. And plants. My aesthetic though is I lots of things. I like a lot of things. I used to love like everything gray and black, but now it tends to be a bit more playful. How is your play in Joburg? I wish I could have been there too. I wasn't there. I'm actually about to watch it online because they recorded it. They're asking because I directed a play.
Oh yeah.
One man play about death and Shakespeare, and apparently it's got very nice reviews. We're going to try and get it on here. We shall see.
It only played in Joburg. It didn't like.
Yeah. So the actor. We rehearsed it here and he knew it was flying there and got me into to work on it with him and then, but knowing that I wasn't going to be able to go there, so I gave him as much guidance as possible and we like dramaturged it and then I'll get to work on it when it comes here if theatre's ever open again.
Yeah, a sobering thought.
What's your favourite song, Sean?
My favourite song, God. Oh, probably something by Chris Whitley or Neil Finn, but too many to. What have I been listening to obsessively recently? God, I can't even say. My latest earworm has been The Day I Tried to Live by Soundgarden.
Okay.
Cornell had a way of writing songs about depression and suicide that are somehow uplifting, even listening to them now that he's passed, possibly through suicide. The Day I Tried to Live is a really gorgeous song. Christian never ages. I don't know. He didn't have those grey hairs when I first met him.
You know, look, there's the sign.
And my hairline wasn't quite here either.
So was it shaved already, were you like, just this is what I'm going to do?
No, well, I mean, this is the only kind of haircut available to me in the lockdown. So it was I looked like Captain Caveman yesterday and until about 10 minutes ago. And then,
nice. I mean, like time, I'm going online with MuggleNet. I've got to shave my head.
Yeah, don't want to scare the kids.
Wait, do you not have an Instagram account?
I do, but I don't really ever use it. I just got that. I think there's a point comes some at some point in your 30s where you're just too old to learn any more social media. So I get on fine with like Facebook and Twitter and stuff, but whenever I tried a new one like Snapchat, I think I was just like, I don't know what these symbols mean. It makes me feel like I'm 800 years old.
You're saying that you're not going to make a TikTok video anytime soon.
Sorry?
You're not going to make a TikTok video anytime soon?
No, I still don't really know what it is or how it differs from many of the others, like Vine or...
It's not so dissimilar to Vine, but it's on phones. I'm not on it, but I'm told.
One of my young friends told me this.
What do you think happened to Carol Baskin's husband? I don't think she killed him. I think they stitch her up a bit in the documentary. There is Tiger King.
Oh, right. I've not been watching it. My partner's been watching Tiger King constantly, but
with her friend while they FaceTime. I've not watched it.
Yeah,
completely insane.
It's really. I have watched it. Yeah, that's what I'm. It's really fun. It's trashy and it's entertaining and it's fun and it's dark and there's great characters. Thank you. That's a nice compliment. I'm so distracted by this constant. Any book recommendations, Sean?
Yes. I've read two books this year. You know, I was just saying yesterday, actually, I think I tweeted about it. You know, it's that nice thing where you read a book and you finish it and it's not just like, I'm glad I read that. It's, I think everyone.
Oh yeah, I saw you mention that.
And one of them was Manufacturing Consent, which I meant to read for years. And I've been aware of the basic thesis of for a long time by Herman.
Okay.
And one of them is a thing called Revolting Prostitutes, which is about the history of the fight for sex workers' rights.
Oh, amazing.
And it's really fascinating and how it's a real education in how a society treats its sex workers ties into almost everything else about society and really tells you a lot. So, yeah, I'd recommend both of them to absolutely anyone. Well, not like 12-year-olds, but...
What's the TLDR on manufacturing consent?
That's liberal the media and liberal democracies, the mainstream media and liberal democracies functions in a propagandistic way, possibly more efficiently than the media in any dictatorship.
Oh,
and it that's clever. Very well.
Hi, Hannah.
Mary, who's the Mary?
Any acting role? Did I? I said Tom Ripley in an interview today. Yeah, I'm too old now, but I probably still feel that way.
Have there been other adaptations of those books other than them?
No, but they're doing one now with Andrew Scott.
Oh.
He's playing Ripley they're doing a TV show. Steve's Alien has adapted it. Yeah. It's for Showtime, maybe, or AMC, I think. Sorry, Duda Iguchi. The questions come so thick and fast. It's not so much about ignoring them. It's seeing them when not answering another one. Yes, I'll totally marry you. hello to my sister, who I see just showed up in chat.
I saw the Jeremy Cass is on here as well.
Hello, Jeremy. Yeah, I see you, Steph. I think also these comments probably come up. Hi, Lucy. These comments probably come up like they're coming up in this rhythmic way, which means they're delayed. Hi to Jobo. You're not the only Jobo person in the room. In fact,
someone just asked, "You are died."
We covered the Czech Republic. We both worked there. I lived there for 2 months. I still have my British day. Some days it slips.
Really,
when you were visiting, I didn't sound.
Not that I remember, but I guess if you sounded slightly mid-Atlantic, it wouldn't have surprised me. So I guess maybe I just didn't really notice.
Hey, Jeremy. Oh, hi, Tom. My brother-in-law is on as well. Oh, the whole family's here.
God, that's so awful. I also got
Julia. I'm not ignoring you on purpose. Hello to Iran. French people have the best sense of humor. Oh, that's an interesting take. What are you holding up?
My next
Shakespeare
book I'm gonna read is Dante's Inferno, and on Christian's advice, I got one with where it's got the Italian and the English facing each other.
Oh, nice. I'm actually just reading the Scottish one that you suggested to me.
Oh yeah, great. There we go.
I have it right here.
Isn't the internet wonderful? Oh, fantastic. I've not bought them yet because I figured I wanted to read a kind of more straightforward translation first before going on to Alistair Gray's one. Sean's face, though. What about my face? What's wrong with my face?
How was playing the Tom Riddle role like? It was... God, I don't know how to answer. That's such a good question. It was one of the great experiences of my life. It was slow, but it was really enjoyable. Being healthy. I'm sort of curious what everyone's doing to survive this time. Like, what's my favorite Marvel movie? I like the bit when he snaps his fingers and half the world dies. The end of that one.
Oh, I've not seen that one. Spoiler.
Well, it's half the universe, in fact. It's actually pretty... I can't remember what the name of that one is, but
yeah, I've seen a trailer, and I've heard people talking about that the bad guy's plan is simply to destroy half of the universe.
Yeah.
Which seems rather arbitrary. What is there? Is there a kind of
underlying... He's like, there's overcrowding, and we need to make room for everyone. It's basically the, the right-wing argument that we need to get rid of. It's okay if old people die. Also, because we need more space. It'll reset culture.
It's like eco-fascism for the universe.
Infinity War, thank you. Please marry me, sure.
May adopt a cat, I suppose.
If you weren't an actor, what would you be?
I used to think I'd want to be a sound engineer.
Yeah, but now? And then what happened?
And then I realized that the music business is even more scattered and unreliable and annoying than our business. So it'd be a strange, it would be an odd sideways step to make.
I feel like a sound engineer, at least, it's worse to be a performer, but sound engineer, at least you'd be like someone who everybody needs all the time. That's how I imagine it. I don't know if that's true.
I mean, I guess so. All the other thing is that it's one of these jobs where you spend all of your time inside, often in rooms with no windows, which I don't think is very good for your mental health, you know. Someone just said, can I slither into this conversation? Very good. I'm a bit worried that my phone might die at some point because they can't get the charger cable to stay in. But so if that happens... If I suddenly...
You might just... What's happened. The whole thing will end.
And you can carry on. No, you can't carry on because this is on the MuggleNet account, which I'm...
That's right.
...in charge of.
I also don't know how long we're supposed to do this for. Not have to do this. I'm very happy to be here. It's nice to talk to people. It's also nice to talk to you and to hear people. yes, you can adopt me, sure. What Quidditch position would Tom Riddle play? I don't know. I'd have to ask Sean. I feel like I'd be the referee.
the mascot, the cox. There is no cox.
Do you have any pets? I don't have pets.
Someone's trying not to fall asleep. I mean, well, you don't have to be here.
give us, I don't know. I don't know how to be just interesting for the sake of it.
Do you speak any other language? I think we've established that we both have a smattering of French, but are fundamentally monolingual, right?
Mm-hmm. Don't marry them, or I won't. I'm not... Neither of us is in London. I'm in New York. Sean's in Glasgow.
Correct. One in Italian. Nothing make of that. What is your favourite, Christian?
What's my favourite what?
That's what I said.
Oh, just my favorite. I'm going to give you a view of what it's like outside here. This is great content.
What's your favorite Christian?
Maybe favorite song? Favorite book? Okay, let's see what's happening outside. Here we go. This is the street. It's where I cut down the street. Yeah, it's actually most cars I've seen all day, but you'll see there's just nobody around. Oh.
Oh.
See, almost all the way.
Still people around. Oh, that's a cool
but not many. Normally it's packed. Right, that's enough of that. Talk about the Harry Potter movies.
Have you seen Beetlejuice? Yeah, not for a long time.
But I saw it on stage recently.
What?
It's here. It's here as a musical.
But is there anything from my childhood that they won't make into a musical? God.
Everything. I don't miss England. I miss people, but I don't miss the place so much.
You don't miss London at all.
Do you know what I do miss sometimes is some of the theatre there. I'm not going to do an American accent here, but if you watch High Fidelity, you can hear me playing an American. Coronavirus. Hey, Lloyd. I've never read fanfics about Tom Riddle.
My favorite Disney movie is Robin Hood, I think.
Oh, is it? That's a nice choice. I loved Aladdin when I was growing up, but I don't know if I would enjoy it now. Who would win in a fight between Voldemort and Grindelwald? I don't know. Probably Voldemort. California, yeah, I like California. Ah, video games. Don't get me started. It's part of the way I've been surviving the last few weeks. Or not surviving. Not been at risk. I'm just how I've been staying sane is what I mean. At the moment, I'm playing Shadow of the Tomb Raider, which is really fun. But my favorite video game is Last of Us. And I do like Destiny, although I'm not playing it much at the moment.
I didn't know you were a gamer.
I know. I keep it quiet.
It's something that
but it is something I've done ever since I was a kid. Yeah.
I kind of naively didn't see the writing on the wall, and when kids were getting into video games, and when I was a kid, I think I just kind of instinctively thought of it as some kind of like passing fad, sort of childish thing that the idea that it would come to being anything like what it is and is actually kind of a really legitimate art form, and that people would continue this interest throughout their lives, just never occurred to me when I was a kid. So I sort of didn't.
Hey Frida, hey Paul. I used to love board games as well, and I still do actually, and although I don't play them very often. But I really love narrative, like video games that do good work with the narrative, which is what makes Last of Us so good. I'm not ignoring you, your name just went, Julia? Do I know the French movie Taxi? Yes, I haven't seen it in a long time. Does Oliver Wood have an Instagram account? He's a fictional character.
That doesn't mean he doesn't have an Instagram. Okay. My favorite stage role I played. Hang on. My favorite stage role that I played is a toss up between when I played John Martin, the musician, in a thing called Solid Air by Doug Lucy, and when I was in this, which is the English translation of A Plaisant by Catherine Antupin, who's a Quebecois playwright.
Where was that on?
We did it in Bath and at the Bush in London and the Traverse in Edinburgh. And I really wish it had come and done off Broadway, and I don't know why it didn't, because it was great. But
has it been done over here at all?
I don't know, actually. There might have been an earlier production of it off Broadway, but it might have been an earlier production of the French version off Broadway, I think, maybe. But
okay.
It's great. And Michael Boyd directed it, and he's just a peerless genius as far as I can see. That was great. Do you like The Witcher? Never seen it.
I haven't watched it. I played about two-thirds of it and then I lost patience, but I did enjoy it.
Well, that was a game.
Yeah. Well, it was originally a book, and then it became a game, and then it became a Netflix show.
Yeah.
I think is right. I don't have any tattoos. I'm the only one of the only people I know who doesn't. Bien sûr.
The kind of cross-medium stuff that's happening these days is really interesting. You watched The Expanse. I've read The Expanse, and that started out as a board game. It was like a role-play game.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
The new season's really good.
Having started reading the books, I didn't really take to the TV show at all. But
yeah, imagine. Close-up of your eyes.
Come to Chile, please. I'd love to come to Chile.
Why does Kristen look like my sister's university professor for science? What can I say? It's one of my talents.
Chameleon. I've never been to Chile, but I'd love to go to Chile, and everyone should watch Ne Pasarán, which is about a fantastic documentary about some Scottish factory workers refusing to work on engines for Pinochet's junta in the 1970s. Check it out, kids.
I gave you a word in French. I gave you two. I gave you bien and sûr. What is your...
Do you have any acting jobs currently? Obviously not.
There's no work to be. Our entire industry is closed down. What inspired you to be an actor, Sean?
Nothing. I fell into it as a child and then never had any better ideas.
Oh, that's right. I forgot that story. Sean was in a movie with that Alan Rickman directed.
Oh, yeah, but I'd already been doing it for years at that point.
Oh, I'm so sorry. He was precocious.
I started working professionally when I was 10.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Just.
What was the first job?
Macbeth at the Tron Theatre.
Yes.
And Ian Glen and Mike Lloyd directed it. And then I didn't see him for 20 years. And then I did right now with him. Can I say something in Russian? Нет.
Hi, I do love Japan. I was there last summer in Tokyo.
I want to go to Japan really badly.
For the
food, apart from anything else. I bought some panko breadcrumbs at the same Asian supermarket today.
I'm sorry you stubbed your toe. What were you doing? Be careful. It's a dangerous world.
How do you become a famous actor and get spotted? Lockout.
Yeah, what's my favorite song? I don't really have a favorite. Do you know what? I've been thinking about Lou Reed's Perfect Day a lot recently. I know it's a cheesy favorite, but I used to see him in the street in the West Village when I lived there and before he died, and I often, like, grew up loving Velvet Underground, and for some reason I often think about that one.
It I can't say song.
Anything. It is a good song.
My favorite singer-songwriter ever is a weird guy called Chris Whitley, who's dead, unfortunately. And he does an amazing cover of Perfect Day on an album which he called Perfect Day, I believe, an album of covers, which I would suggest you check out.
Wait, who does it?
Chris Whitley. He's a Texan singer, okay. Guitar player. It's him that plays those weird metal guitars that I was trying out in that store.
Oh, yeah. What are those called? They have, like, a specific name?
Yeah, it's called a resonator.
Resonator.
I've got one, man.
Wait, so you bought one somewhere else, you already had one?
I already had one. But it's a relatively cheap one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's cool. I love that color.
It's like the front cover of Brothers of Arms, you know?
Ooh.
Brothers in Arms? Brothers of Arms? That's not a thing.
Everyone stop commenting so that I can have a conversation. That's good.
Donald Gleason reminds Susie of us both.
Us both.
I mean that's like, yeah, I don't know what the similarities are really, but oh,
what's Hi Brady? Do you? I play the drums. Sean, ask Sean about instruments. He plays guitar. He was just showing you.
Yeah, I play guitar. That's what's keeping me sane during this time. Is the little.
What is your Hogwarts house, Sean?
The harem here, Gryffindor.
Okay.
Obviously. On this one.
Favorite kind of characters to play. Favorite kind of character to play. I don't really think of it like that. I guess usually one that somehow I feel like I have something emotional to say about. I have seen Killing Eve the first season. I liked it very much.
I'm
what lizard? What lizard?
I've done a Fringe Festival show. Have you done a Fringe Festival show, Christian?
A Fringe Festival show? What's that?
Fringe Festival show, like an Edinburgh show.
Oh, Fringe. Oh, yeah. When I was a teenager, I did a ton. And then at university, we used to play at the George Square Theatre. Yeah, when I was growing up.
Footlights?
No, I wasn't in Footlights. They were comedy. I did, but National Youth Music Theatre, we did George Square, and then we did one at college. We did one in the streets of Edinburgh. We did Henry the Fourth Part One that Josie directed in the streets of Edinburgh. What do you think about the second actor who played Tom Riddle? He's great. Frank Delane. He's great.
Yeah, you would say that.
Do you prefer acting in theatre or cinema? I like both for different reasons. Do you have a preference?
I crave whichever one I'm not doing.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Interesting.
There are such differences in pros and cons, and I always miss when I'm doing one, I miss the other.
Yeah. Filming's not really an actor's medium, but it's well rewarded and it's really enjoyable. I love being like the collaboration of it. How is Bonnie? I haven't spoken to her in a couple of years, but last time I spoke to her, she was great.
We were in Rome with Bonnie a couple of years ago.
That's right. That's right. That's the last time I saw her, I think. Are you friends with Emma Watson? No, but I would say hi to her if I passed her in the street.
Yeah, no, I got on with her at the time, but we don't keep in touch.
What kind of makeup did they do to you when you played Tom? Not very much, but they did straighten my hair for 5 hours every morning.
Really?
Yeah, I would have. So the idea was to not have a wig, so it didn't take so long to get ready. But then the actual process took about 2 to 3 hours. It was 2 to 3 hours. It wasn't five.
2 to 3 hours to sort your hair out?
Yeah.
And give you like a side shed? Good lord.
Was Dan short? Dan was like 12, so he was not tall.
Well, he's still not tall, is he?
Yeah, 5 hours was an exaggeration. I'm sorry, don't trust anything I say. What other HP actors do you keep in touch with? I think Sean's the only one, other than the ones that I run into at conventions sometimes. Still at 20 years, that's so nice. It's not. It's just very good light, or your internet connection is doing me favors. favorite dog breed is probably beagle. Thanks for watching Most Out in the Jungle.
I'm going to ask you an emergency question.
Yes, an emergency question.
Book of emergency questions.
Oh, okay.
All right, hang on.
This is very exciting. I don't know.
Do you wash your legs when you're having a shower?
Do I wash my legs? Yeah, of course. Otherwise, my legs would get dirty.
I see, of course.
Do you not?
It's not my questions.
Don't you have you don't have a feeling about that one?
I mean, yeah, I wash my legs when I'm having a shower.
Okay.
Thank God. What's the strangest thing that's ever happened to you in a taxi cab?
Oh, that's easy. I at about 2 a.m, I was moving out of a place I'd been house-sitting in the East Village. This was about 4 years ago. And I got into an Uber share at 2 a.m. And sitting in the back seat was someone I had met in Berlin 5 years before, who was a friend of a friend, a choreographer, who was also traveling in the Uber share. She didn't even live in New York, and she just happened to be sitting in the back of the cab when I got in.
That's wild.
That was crazy. Yeah. What about you? What's the strangest thing that's ever happened in the back of a cab?
I once was suddenly extremely nauseated in the back of a cab and had to vomit with so little warning. Oh. I didn't have time to ask him to pull over or even to roll a window down. In an act of sheer altruism, because I didn't want to ruin this guy's cab, vomited down the sleeve of my own jacket and managed not to get any
of it.
What?
In the guy's taxi cab.
But just in your jacket.
Yeah.
That's so thoughtful of you.
Yeah, right? Nice guy over here.
Yeah, that's much nicer than I was when I have been sick in a cab and I was not as thoughtful as you. I wish I had the same book so I could ask you the question. Oh my God, you're a saint. You're a saint, Sean.
I'm a saint. Oh, don't know about that.
I think it's in response to your story.
You should see what I do on the bus. Would you rather have a hand made out of ham or an underarm that dispenses sun cream lotion? Sun lotion, sun cream lotion, that's a tautology.
I mean, I think I'd rather have an underarm that dispenses suntan lotion because it would be more useful.
Really?
Than a ham hand?
You live in a... Well, but food's always useful. Sun cream. Well,
if you're going to, you're saying eat, you would eat your own hand in those circumstances.
Yeah, I think you can eat it and then it grows back.
Okay. I mean, I guess I don't like ham enough.
Well, still, a source of calories for emergencies.
And someone keeps asking if I've read Ursula Le Guin, and the answer is yes. But only the Earth trilogy.
I keep meaning to.
What's he reading?
Well, I'm not even sure.
I read the Earthsea trilogy. I was obsessed with it. We have on the shelf Left Hand of Darkness to read.
What's an MBTI type?
What's a what?
What's an MBTI Sorry. Type? I was asked. We were asked what our MBTI types were, and I don't know what that is.
I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. I love coffee. Coffee's honestly is like it's a problem.
Yeah, snap.
Myers-Briggs personality type and yeah.
I order full French roast beans by the kilo.
Oh, good work. Why don't you post so much photo of you on Insta? Because I really enjoy posting photos of things that I'm looking at rather than of myself. Unless someone else takes the picture. I don't really like taking selfies. Is the honest answer.
Coffee or espresso? Oh, it depends what mood I'm in.
American coffee. Danish style.
What's Danish style?
It's like how most... It's like pour over. Like Monmouth Coffee Company is the sort of London equivalent, I guess. But it's like medium to light roast. See, I'm such a nerd. Medium to light roast. Made either in an AeroPress or with a pour over.
So is that like just after the first crack?
Just after, what's that, just after the first crack?
The roast.
Oh, I don't know. It means they're kind of like a lighter brown.
Right, because there's that thing that when the roasters do where like, there's an audible crack. There are two audible cracks at different stages of the roasting process. Like that's actually part of how they know like how far along it is, as they listen for the crack.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Sorry.
See, you learn. It's a school day. favorite restaurant in NYC?
Where would we be eating if I was there, Christian, if this hadn't happened?
It's... Favorite restaurant? God, that's a good question. I really love... I love Momofuku Noodle. Oh, Momofuku-san is probably my favorite place to go eat. But everything's closed at the moment. Oh, I love Uncle Boone's as well, Uncle Boone's sister. For delivery and Uncle Boone's itself for regular. It's my favorite place in New York. I like being by the river.
Our apartments in New York are too expensive.
They are. I rent.
Is it still the most expensive property market in the world, Manhattan?
No, I think San Francisco is.
Really? Jesus. All because of all the
new I think so.
Tech money, right?
I love Italy. I hope you're doing okay over there. Would you dropkick Dumbledore? Guess it depends who was playing him. and what he just said to me.
Yeah, dropkick Michael Gambon. How will that?
Yeah, I don't think he would probably dropkick you back. Dropkick you first. Uncle Boone's is a Thai food restaurant. Yeah, I don't have a dog.
There was a when I was in New York in like 2004 or something. I remember there being a great Thai place in Brooklyn. Well, I say it was great. Actually, I hadn't had much Thai, but it was probably the first good Thai place that I went to several times, because there wasn't much Thai food here at the time. But was it called C or something? But
oh yeah, C. C's in Williamsburg.
Oh, is it still there?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I don't know, who knows now, but yeah. Was Alan Rickman as amazing as they imagine?
Yeah, more. I'd love to visit Cape Town, but never have.
I was there for Christmas. It was amazing. And a really strange place, but the most naturally beautiful place I've ever been. And then this extraordinary economic disparity that's really like, it's as if all the world's problems are like compressed into one tiny place.
So it's like the Edinburgh Festival.
Well, but also with the legacies of like racism and apartheid, and it's amazing. You can drive past the most extraordinary houses you've ever seen and come around the corner and there's like slums all the way to the horizon and people sort of living right next to it. It's really but it's the same thing that's happening around the world, just right next to each other instead of hidden out of view. And then landscape unlike anything I've ever seen, which is changing because of global warming. I suppose we should wrap this up because I can't imagine anyone is still interested in what I have to say.
How many people are looking at this? Well, I think, is that...
189, right now. We've varied around 200 or so. I wish I could read Arabic, but I can't. I'm sorry.
There's no way we can... Oh. Snape Severus.
I have been to Birmingham. I started a tour of the UK doing Feston there, and I've seen Parasite. Loved it.
Feston, that's when you came to Glasgow, when you were doing Feston.
That's when I came to Glasgow as well.
The time that I saw Feston, I'd only ever seen two Danish things. One of them was Feston, of course, which is a black comedy about incest. And I'd just seen a movie called The Art of Crying, which is a black comedy about incest. And I what on earth is going on over there?
Oh, yeah, well. Incest, but make it funny.
Yeah, well.
It's Denmark.
You need to laugh, don't you? That's not Arabic, that's Persian. Sorry.
Does anyone have any suggestions in comments on how to survive? Because I think it's obviously I have friends who work in hospitals. It's a completely different experience for them, and it's a completely different experience for people who are ill or have been ill. But there's this thing of being like, how being asked to stay at home and do nothing is somehow easy, and it's really like, it's not hard in some ways, but it's mentally like taxing. In this other way, I feel like people can go crazy so easily. So I'm curious what other people are doing to that made me laugh. Incest, but make it funny. Christian 2020. I wonder what suggestions people have. They're reading all the Harry Potter books. Okay, that's good. I already read them though. A lot of online multiplayer games. Nice. Home workout. I did one of those. I've been in pain for 3 days and I haven't been able to do another one. Talk to friends on the phone and have Zoom parties. Yes. Memes help. Yeah. Video games. Cooking new stuff. Oh, yeah.
I feel like the lifetime of being an actor has kind of prepared me for it, in the sense that people are finding it very psychologically difficult for the routine to suddenly be taken away from them, and I've never had one. Like there is no what a week should feel like to me, because it's just been so erratic. Sometimes I'm traveling all the time. Sometimes I'm getting up at 5 a.m. to work. Sometimes I'm not working till evening. Sometimes I'm not working at all. Like, I don't have any expectations of what they should be, you know, really.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I would have thought I would find it easier, actually, when you put it like that. But I really rely on distracting myself, I guess, with errands and things, the gym, seeing friends. Cleaning with music on keeps you occupied. Oh, that's nice. I should probably do some cleaning.
I wish I had cleaning.
Learn a Scottish accent. Well, Sean would probably not get much out of that. And my mum is Scottish, so not sure what I would spend the time doing.
There are some Scottish accents I would struggle with, but right, I'm going to go, guys, because I'm worried that my phone's going to die, and if it dies, Cat wants me to save this rather than delete it, and I'm worried that it will automatically delete if it ends by me.
Oh, okay, fine. You bring us to a close then, Sean.
Well, you said a few minutes ago we should wrap this up. Shut up.
No, you're right. Maybe we'll do it again.
Yeah, maybe.
So this is a nice way to say hello to you also. And it's really lovely hearing from everyone around the world. Thanks for saying hi.
Hi, putting up with
this,
this
nonsense.
Good.
All right, then. I'm going to log off. Love you all.
Take care, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.